What's up, everybody? Good to see you guys out here again. Thank you first and foremost for following me and watching my videos. I know somebody different, somebody new, somebody cool. But anyways, I want to get back up to you. Now, some of my videos, as you probably already seen, the first two have been kind of lag. They're in the back, in the past, beginning on, I believe, the 16th is when Gen 2 came out. But I had all that material and I wanted to go ahead and get it out, and I had to learn how to go ahead and edit these videos and everything like that. I had actually made a video and I made it, and I think I put it out probably like 2 or 3 days after the 16th, but I didn't buy the programming. And so when I finished doing the whole video and everything like that, it had a big, huge watermark right across the middle. I was like, yo, I can't do that. Like, I even published it on YouTube, and then I was like, I can't do that. So I actually went ahead and purchased a different program. I couldn't do it with that one no more. Even though I had learned how to do it on that one, I liked the program itself and the ease of actually moving things around. I had to learn in an entirely different program in order to get started and start redo everything over again. So I had to do everything over again. So right now it is the 26th, and everything. And I still have videos from the 17th, 18th, 19th, all the way up to the 26th. I even recorded some more stuff today in my travels. But I did want to give you a heads up and give you some news that pertains to right now. So, as many of you, let's do 2 days back. 2 days ago, Pokemon Go tweeted out that the app was being updated for 0.57.3 for Android and 1.27.3 for iOS, Apple. Just implement some improvements. But now to today, which is the beginning of Pokemon Day. 21 years ago. 21 years ago. Pokemon was released, and everybody came to find out and love these imaginable monsters. Charmander, Bulbasaur, Pikachu. You know, Gen 1 was released, and this was the beginning of what we have now. So being today as Pokemon Day, February 26, 2017, and probably every other February 26 in the future will forever be known as Pokemon Day. So what Niantic decided to do is throw a festivity for it. So right now, Pikachu has a wonderful hat on, a festive hat, like a birthday hat on his head. He's out in the wild. I have not seen him yet. And maybe that's because I've been walking around in areas where he's not shown. So obviously they're not doing it like they did with the Christmas event where Pikachu had a Santa hat on and he was popping up everywhere. Like, I have tons of Santa hat Pikachus right now, but maybe he's still around somewhere. Maybe, you know, if you guys have seen him, you know, post up a picture, tweet me. I'll put my little Twitter down there. Tweet me a picture of Pokemon Go with the festive Pikachu. I still haven't seen him. Hopefully see him soon. Probably in the next day or whatnot. But so just to give you a heads up, I might actually be combining 2 days into this video right here, which I think I'll probably be, which is February 17th and February 18th, in my little travels across the United States and hunting down the new generation plus the old generation, Gen 1 and Gen 2 of Pokemon. So, hopefully you'll enjoy, and I will catch up with you guys later. Alright, just chilling out the spot and everything like that. Got a Wooper here. And a spin rat. Chilling, so gonna catch this spin rat real quick and see what's up, man. You got it. It's been a wonderful time at the beginning of this Gen 2. I'm at home. I got stuff popping up. The guy, he just pops up like that. So it's been amazing and everything like that. And just like that. Gotcha. You know, what made them say gotcha? And by the way, that's my 5-day streak right there. First throw, bonus, registered to the Pokédex. Boom! How you like me now? What, 400? But we ain't done. We got a Wooper here. And it's only got two spikes on the side. 218. Razz it up. Oh, sorry. I'm not feeling that good. Actually, I am. I'm just tired and everything like that. That's a bad throw. But I'm tired and working hard and everything. And then trying to get all this together has been very, very hard for me. Trying to learn things and the fact that I can't do certain, you know, try to edit some of this stuff as much as I want to and put it out there as quickly as possible. So I'm going to be doing a little testing on what I want to do in order to try to catch up. Since this video is really from the 18th, I mean, excuse me, my bad, the 17th. So it's a little bit behind, but we're going to catch up. As you can see, this is where I live and everything like that, and there's really no Pokestops around. And cut straight back into another Wooper. 369. This one has double spikes coming out of his head. So this one is definitely a different gender. Yeah, that's the word I was looking for. Different gender. So if you haven't noticed already that the Pokemon now have gender types, and some of them you can actually tell which ones are male and female. With the Wooper, the ones with the just one, I guess they're like branches or something like that, right? One branch. I'm gonna say one branch coming out of their ears, out of the little thing. Then that's a female. The one with the double branches, those are males. Yeah, water and rock type. First throw, gotcha, boom. And there you go, see male right there. Mud shot, body slam. Caught in Irving, Texas, where I live. Venomat, not even trying to get it. Let's go into my Pokédex, see what I've caught. And you see where you spin right. And do this boy there is. Recrawl. Caught two hatched two Pichus. From the eggs, finally, you know what I'm saying? It's been a while. It was the only last baby Pokemon I needed. Caught a whole lot today. Sentrance and everything like that. Knocked out. Hoot. A lot of Sentrance over there. And look at this. Right here. A Sneasel. A 1335 Sneasel. Just popped up in the airport in Minneapolis, St. Paul. So, you got Faint Attack, Ice Punch. This is like one of the coolest Pokemon of Gen 2. I mean, look how cool it is. Like, what? That's a hip-hop Pokemon right there. Not likely to make much. IV's not that good, but it is a 1335. It's up there. I'm keeping it. Got a Hop Hip. Along with a couple others. Going around there, and there goes the Jinxes again from the Mall of America.
I mean, the Mall of America, man, I'm telling you, Jinx life. If you need Jinx, go to Mall of America. Swing up, self all over in there. Centric everywhere. Kind of like a rat-a-tat. And everything like that. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I'm just probably need to get something to drink real quick, but spin rack is another spin rack right here. I don't get a lot of stuff that pops up at my apartment, but I tell you this, every once in a while something good does pop up, and it's pretty good. I don't have to go outside the house and everything. I know some people is not that lucky. I'm so sorry. Excuse me if I sound like, this guy's gonna be sick. Just need some rest. But I do want to get this out to you. So we're just gonna push on, get this done, and everything like that. Unable to connect to server. This happened a lot at the beginning of when Gen 2 came out. Failed to log in. I'm already logged in. How am I failed to log in if I'm already in the game? So, following that error, blah, 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 get out of here. Gonna have to reset the game and see if we can get back and figure out. Spin rack went away. Or is it just because I'm trying to catch him? Waiting for you. It's thinking. It's thinking. It is so thinking. Ah. And there we go. Check that out. Erdos. It's Spinarak's evolution right there, and I don't even have to evolve it. So, let me give you an explanation about some of the stuff that I do differently. A lot of people want to catch them all. Once they get enough candies, they evolve into some of the ones that they can't catch all the time, like Magikarp. You can catch a bunch of Magikarp, but you'll rarely find a wild Gyarados, right? Well, for me, in order to keep the game going and interesting throughout, you know, the slow times where you've caught everything and all that, it gets boring. Like, you've caught everything. So what's next? You're just going to keep catching Rattatas, and now that Gen 2 has come out, you're going to keep catching Sentrets. So in order to keep me going out and exploring and having fun with the game and gaining my XP, excuse me, I don't evolve anything unless I've caught it twice. So perfect example, Charizard. I don't have a Charizard yet. Gen 2's out, I still don't have a Charizard. Why? Because I have not caught, not even one. I haven't caught one Charizard. I seen one in the wild and ran away. And so I'm not gonna evolve my Charmeleon into Charizards because I feel that this will make me want to go out and try to find the Charizard even more. If I can finally evolve twice, capture it twice, then I can go ahead and start evolving the lower evolutions into that. And that's how I've been able to keep the game interesting to me and keep it flowing and keep going out and exploring things like that. I might have to change that up just a little bit and just go for, looky here, Dunsparce right here. I'm just sitting in my apartment, and it's actually sitting in the apartments across the parking lot, but not high CP, 109, but you know what? Brand new Pokemon to the Pokedex. That's all we want, right? Right now. So, let's see. Come on, come on, come on, come on. 1, 2, 3. Gotcha. That's what's up. Yeah. So, Dunsparce caught first throw, too. Awesome. But like I was saying, I might have to change it up just a little bit and actually change it to where, as long as I've caught it once, Ursaring, the evolved form of Tedder Ursa. Pretty strong too, 1987. How many of you guys were born in 1987? Anyone? And then I get a Teddy Ursa right after it. But, what was I saying? Kind of lost my train of thought. Oh, I might have to change it to where if I catch one of the evolved, then I'll just go ahead and evolve the ones I catch after that. In order just to, because I've already caught it, and it's already in the Pokedex as a wild one, and everything, because it, like I said, I haven't even caught a Charizard yet, but, and they're so rare that when would I must be able to see a second one right away, so, it's going to be hard, I don't know, I have to think about it, I might just do that, once I catch it, in the wild, then I'm free to go ahead and evolve from the lower species. Might have to do that. What do you guys think? Let me know. I know one thing. I'm just not going to evolve it, even though I don't have it. So I'm not going to have a Charizard until I catch one. But let me know if I should just continue my stance on catching two in the wild before evolving. Or should I just keep it, or should I drop it down to just catching one in the wild and then evolving from there? Right now, so as you can see, it's daytime on the game now. And this is because when I was catching those early ones, it was during the night, you know what I'm saying? Right after midnight and everything like that. As you saw, I had my 5-day streak catching Pokemon. And this is down in Fort Worth, Texas, and I was actually on my way to the stockyards, check out the stockyards and everything. I really don't know how my way around there, so that's why the directions kept popping up at the top of the screen. But headed to the stockyards, actually gonna go see, you know, just chill out there, see the scenery. Get some stuff from the souvenir camp. Also, every day, every single day, from once at 11:30 and once at 4 p.m., they have Longhorn cattle walk through the streets with real cowboys showing the way through the streets. And they do that twice a day, once at 11 a.m. and once at 4:30 p.m. And it's just interesting. Something different to see. You rarely see, you know, Longhorn cattle anywhere. And, you know, Texas is known for them. So, went down to Fort Worth for the first time to check it out and see what this spectacular. And everybody always talked about, oh, you gotta go down to the stock show, blah, 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 blah. I get down there and it's like literally one street. The rest of the part of the place is just like blah. It's one street. Some expensive restaurants over there. Just gonna go get a steak. Yo, that was one. Yeah, I mean everything was like $35 or more. I mean you can't put a price on a great steak. I'm like, did y'all just slaughter like one of those Longhorns back there? But it is really expensive over there. So I didn't eat there. I ate at another restaurant there. Ooh. Is that a Bailey? Or a Chicoria? Can't see the screen anymore. As you see, I'm going down the street, cruising down in my 6-4. Jocking these Pokemon. Trying to make my way down to the stockyards. I'm actually driving, and I posted have a little magnet thing that holds my phone on my dashboard. So, oh man, look, it's another Sneasel. I'm at a stoplight right here. I know that. I remember that. I remember I'm sitting at a stoplight. And it ran. I tried to Pokemon Go it, and I shouldn't have. I should have caught it on my own. So it's a real bummer that, you know, I tried to get that out of Pokemon Go Plus. Sneezing ran away from me. Yeah. Could have had two Sneasels already in the first 2 days, but I didn't catch them. That sucks. Really, I really like Sneasel. Like, he's like the hip hop Pokemon right now. Especially in Gen 2. Duck. So, I don't know. Just, doesn't it sadden you? I mean, the Pokemon Go Plus is a great device. And since I do end up in a lot of airports and everything, it's hard for me to sit there with my phone out trying to swipe to get Pokestops and everything like that. It's great for that. Even when I'm driving, I just hook up my Pokemon Go Plus and I put in my sun visor at the top, at the very top, and then I just drive, and then when it turns blue, I just hit it real quick, and I'm still driving. I'm not distracted as much, and either it, you know, gets the Pokestop or it doesn't. That way, I can keep my excuse me, I can keep going and everything. I'm not having my phone in my hand. Every once in a while, when I hit stoplights or whatnot, I'm getting in the kilometers for that, the little kilometers for trying to hatch my eggs and everything like that. So it's a good thing to go. So if you don't have one, you should go get one. Try to find one, especially Gen 2's out now. It'll be awesome. And everything like that. So you should really, really check it out. So this actually, I'm just going ahead and stop it right here, because the rest of it is, I did it while I was Pokemon Go. I really didn't get no footage while I was down in the stockyards. But I'll probably go back. There's a lot of Pokestops. Well, not a lot, but there's quite a few Pokestops down there. And let's see what kind of Pokemon are there. All right, you can see Niantic was still having problems with the servers, I guess, because a lot of people were logging back on because Gen 2 was out. But as you can see, there's no Pokestops or anything around or anything. So it just became seeing the land and the mini highway streets and everything on the way to the Stargard. So really sucks. I really wish I got more footage while I was down in the Stargard, but I didn't. So we're gonna catch up. I'm gonna keep speeding up these process, these videos, and hopefully I'll be caught up pretty soon and then put them out on a regular basis. Whether it's every day, I don't know, because between work and here and that, it's really hard. But definitely, you know, several times a week, you will get a video from me. So that'll be a good thing. And until then, I guess I will just see you in the future. So keep it. Best thing to do, I want to thank you for watching once again. I appreciate the support. Go ahead and hit like on this video. And If you like it, thumbs up on it. If anything, give me some suggestions down at the bottom so I can make these videos, improve them and everything. But definitely subscribe. Sit down there and subscribe, and so you know when I do post up a new video, which should be again sometime this week, hopefully within the next day or two. So thank you for the support once again. I'll see you soon. Definitely.